Hi guys, and welcome back. If you have never visited my channel before, thank you for watching. My name is Sarah, and today I'm going to be doing a video. I just kind of wanted to focus on my top 5 product recommendations, and these are products that I would actively recommend to a friend. I have actively recommended to my friends and family, and products that I have repurchased as well. These aren't favorites, these are truly holy grails. Cannot live without. As soon as it runs out, I will repurchase. And if I repurchase something, it's pretty significant because I like to try out products on a very regular basis. At the end of the video, I will also be talking about some products that I just got kind of new in for my collection and products that I will be trying out for the next however long in hopes that it will become kind of a repurchased item. So the first product that I wanted to mention was the Jergens Skin Firming Moisturizer. It says it reduces the appearance of cellulite for visibly firmer skin. Toning moisturizer. I definitely feel like this helps to tone or firm my skin as much as I think a moisturizer can. What I really like it is that it is very fast in sinking into the skin. It doesn't leave a residue. And what I have found is I hate putting on lotion. I don't like the way it makes my hands feel. And I just don't like the lotion on my hands. And so I will take my tanning mitt and I will actually moisturize with a tanning mitt, which sounds kind of extra to be honest. But if you're like me and you don't like lotion on your hands, try using a mitt. If you have a tanning mitt, because it works so well, and it kind of encourages me to go ahead and moisturize, and usually I'm pretty bad about that. My next recommendation is a fragrance, and this is the Jo Malone fragrance in Basil and Neroli. This is my current favorite, but Jo Malone fragrances as a whole are a recommendation for me. So I keep this one in the box because I just got it and I just think it's so cute and pretty, and I do have my Jo Malone boxes that my others have come in, but then I also have these two. So all together I have 3 Jo Malone fragrances. Jo Malone products are expensive, I'm not gonna lie. They are, like, you're gonna be putting down some money. These are the smallest ones, and the small ones are $65. The large ones, I believe, are $120. I really would like to buy the large one someday, but that's when I really feel like paying $120, but I know that I will go through these, so that's kind of the price you pay. So here I have Wood Sage and Sea Salt, Peony and Blush Suede, and then Basil and Neroli. Basil and Neroli is my favorite. Peony and Blush Suede is really pretty, very floral, and then Wood Sage and Sea Salt is a fragrance that I use to mix or tone down, especially I use it in conjunction with Peony and Blush Suede to kind of tone down that floral smell. Jo Malone, it's called cologne and it is meant to be unisex. And I highly agree. I think that Peony and Blush Suede is more floral, so I probably would say that is a more feminine fragrance. But I find that these fragrances also smell very different on different people. These are my top recommendations because these are the ones that I actually wear, especially Basil and Neroli. But if you're looking for a new fragrance and you're looking for a fragrance when you hate perfume, because I used to hate perfume, I really hated perfume. Jo Malone is a great alternative because I wouldn't call it a perfume. I would call it more of a fragrance, a cologne, a unisex scent. My next recommendation, I think I've talked about this before. This is the Estee Lauder Micro Cleansing Balm. This is also quite a pricey product for a cleanser. It's a $45 cleanser, I believe. So that's a lot. I'm not even gonna lie. It smells like lavender, I believe. It does smell like lavender, and I'm trying to think of what else other scents are in it. I think it's pretty much just lavender. And it is a balm cleanser. I don't know, you can kind of see that. And then you rub it into your hands, it turns into an oil, you put it on your face, breaks down all the makeup, and then when water comes into contact with it, it turns into a white milk that you can just wipe off. How I do work for Estee Lauder. This is something that I have repurchased twice now, I think. And then before that, I had a little sample jar that they gave us when they launched. How I demonstrate to customers is I will let them see how it melts on the hand, and then I have a spray bottle and I'll spray it and you can see the white milk. How I use it at home is what I'll do is I'll take a little bit of the cleanser, put it in my hand, let it warm up and turn into oil, massage it into my face with my makeup on. This is the only cleanser I use. I put it all over my face, let everything break down, and then I'll either take a warm washcloth or I'll take my Clarisonic. I'll wet the Clarisonic and then I'll take my Clarisonic to make sure that it is an extremely gentle cleanser. So I want to make sure it is cleansing because it's not going to be quite as harsh as, say, like a gel or a foam cleanser. I highly, highly recommend this. This has helped my skin a lot as my skin tends to break out more if I'm using a harsher cleanser. Gentler cleanser seems to work better. My next recommendation is Loving Tan Deluxe Bronzing Mousse. I have three right now, though this one is my mom's. We like Loving Tan. So I have purchased Loving Tan. This is my second bottle, I think. Second or third bottle, one of these. I buy Ultra Dark, and then my mom, I raved about it, got my mom on it. She has medium, but Loving Tan is so, so nice. I have talked about this before. I won't rave about it too much. It is cheaper than Saint Tropez. It is better than Saint Tropez. It's amazing. And my last product recommendation is the Double Wear Stay in Place Makeup Double Wear Foundation. This is by Estee Lauder. It's been around forever. I don't go a day of working with Estee Lauder and I don't sell this. It is a very full coverage foundation. It can be very heavy. I find it to be very comfortable. I find it not to be heavy because I use a very, very small amount of it, which I like. I've had this bottle for almost a year. Granted, I don't wear this foundation every day. If I'm doing something where I want something I can trust and I don't want to think about it, I use Double Wear. I like this foundation because it is very skin-like. I enjoy the way that it makes my skin look. It has a beautiful finish. I can't see it. It doesn't look powdery. I can't see that I have foundation on and it blends beautifully. I also like that I can kind of manipulate it because it's so full coverage. I'm able to mix it with moisturizer and kind of make a tinted moisturizer kind of deal. And that way I'm able to manipulate it a little bit better and then use the pure foundation on places that I feel I need more coverage. But this is a fantastic foundation. I've worn it to like football games, like any place hot. Like this will not move. I can promise you. Best foundation on the market, in my opinion, not gonna lie, like that is my statement. Best foundation that is out there. So those are my product recommendations. Those are the products that I am absolutely in love with and I continue to repurchase. And then some of the new in to my collection. This is the MAC Next to Nothing Powder. All of these new in are MAC products because my last like kind of makeup buy was at MAC. And this is the Next to Nothing Powder. I am trying this. I do love it so far. The guy that I was talking to, his name was Samson. And I'm going to leave his Instagrams, because he has several, down below because he's just a really cool guy. And he is a very talented artist. And he was just really sweet. I told him that I needed a powder for somebody that hates powders. Like really, I don't enjoy using them. And he recommended this. I said, I've heard of the mineralized skin finish, and he was like, hey, I love the mineralized skin finish, but as soon as this came out, I love this even more. So, Next to Nothing powder in Light Plus. The next product that I just got was part of the Juicy collection. Juicy? Tutti Frutti? I don't know. It's Tutti Frutti Juicy something. It's the one with that kind of packaging, and this is called Delicates, and it's a bronzing powder. And I know that this is limited edition, but it sounds like they come out with this same bronzer in the different collections sometimes, and last time it was in the Work It Out collection, and then they brought it back in this Tutti Frutti Juicy something tropical something collection. Beautiful bronzer. I'm wearing it today. I'm wearing the powder as well today. It's a beautiful bronzer. It's kind of an olive tone, which is amazing. I think this is so, so pretty. It is not very pigmented, I will say that, which I enjoy. I find that people want face products that are super, super pigmented when really it's much nicer to work with something, say, and I mean like blushes, bronzers kind of deal. Working with products that are less pigmented so you can build them up. You're not wanting it to be like an eyeshadow where you're wanting a true strong color, especially with blushes and bronzers, because you can go so, it can go very wrong if they're, you know, you just pack on a ton. This, you need to build it up, and I even use it with a pretty soft brush as well, something that does not pick up a lot of product. So I do build this and I just keep going, which I enjoy because I really love bronzer and I love to put it on, and the more I can put on, the better for me. And having it not be very pigmented is very forgiving and kind of balances my heavy hand when it comes to bronzer. Beautiful, big fan so far. We'll see how it goes. And then the final product that I'm going to be talking about that I just got is the MAC Strobe Cream. This is in Silverlite. I've heard a lot about MAC Strobe Creams, and I did, I put this on under my makeup once. I forgot to do it today because I'm the worst with putting things under my foundation. Like, I forget, but I really need to start using this more. But when I did use it, it has a very unique texture. And I really, really enjoyed it. This is a silver tone, and you can use it over your foundation, mixed in your foundation, under your foundation. We mixed it with a highlighter, a purple tone highlighter, which I will hopefully be getting in very soon. And it created a beautiful space-like highlight. It is a strobing and highlighting cream, something you can mix in. It is a liquid. And so far I really like it. I haven't used this, I probably used this one the least so far compared to the other products, but I have never heard anything bad about strobe cream, so there's that. Okay, and that is all of the product recommendations and new products that I'm trying currently. I hope you enjoyed this kind of setup. I just wanted to kind of have a little chit chat about some products that I really, really like. If you have any product recommendations that are products that you continually repurchase and are obsessed with, leave them down below. If you have any questions about the products that I've talked about, also leave them down below. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like it if you did. It doesn't do anything except for make me happy. And please subscribe to my channel if you aren't already. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.